Ulangilam kalyam prasha ubadiru menteri ramba barim ke jalla u dr mukul sama ulakan tho ya ke sarkar ba ke jing kerdu pisa kedai namar bajor ke jingle bian khamtam ha ke baidi ba ke jing khai bian yu doyong ha ke ba ke sarkar kam yo satya ya ke khajna ulai thu bola ju yo jing tip bahadu menta ke kali ke doyong ki ya lalon klem dan kam ban seu khajna sha ke sarkar ulong ba ki babon ki kam ba ke sarkar kedai ban pendep kilasa tenglut khamtam ki bala ban pinmi pisa na ga banta ga jalla shushu ulong ba sarkar ha ga jaka ban pin slur ki breu ban te ye ki kam lajong hendai menta na ga jingbom la ban pinyo pisa kala pin kanan dien ki bubon ba tre kam lajong bat kane kala ru ban wanra ya ga jingma ha ki por ban wan na mar baro kin yele ban phai ban yo ya ka kam sarkar
there is a sudden dislocation of the circulation of fund flow resulting in dislocation of economic activities. This has brought in miseries in the minds of people. The sales have gone down. You ask all the shopkeepers, whether during the puja or even preceding this, sales have gone down. So, unless government understands its responsibility to ensure circulation of fund through economic activities, this phenomenon is going to further dampen the spirits of our young men and women, discourage them from becoming an entrepreneur, and you will find more and more people lining up for government jobs. You'll have more and more pressure on government job, and that is not a good trend. That is not a good trend. Now, why will they have money? I just have one WhatsApp input here. Coal trucks and even the pickups, which are stealing coal without paying revenue. How will the government get money? This is happening. Everyone knows it. You know it. Who doesn't know it? Come on, tell me. Yeah. I have here, I just got it when I sat here to talk. Pictures of illegally, coal being illegally transported without paying the royalty to the government. And you know how many months the district councils have not received salary. This royalty is also shared with the district council. It is not just the state government's share. And look at the ramification of the this government with a complete disregard to the concerns of the state. So there is no point in remaining in denial mode. They should say, okay, what? The opposition is saying, okay, we take cognizance and take corrective measures. We have always done that. If somebody is bringing to our notice anything that is not expected to be just ignored, then we have to be seen as responding. And this is what we have done during our time.